Today's Illustrator tutorial is how to make this cool hand lettering effect using Adobe Illustrator. Welcome back to Satori Graphics, everybody, home of graphic design content. Today I have a tutorial based around the amazing work of David. He's a designer on Instagram that I follow. You can check out his work because he has some seriously cool hand lettering designs on his Instagram account. Let's jump right into this tutorial. You can use custom hand lettering, but today I really didn't have the time for that, so I use a script typeface. And there's a link in the description below for the download of this typeface that I'm using here. If you want to edit the actual lettering, you're going to need to create outlines, and then it helps to ungroup each individual letter. Once happy, create a black rectangle across the entire artboard, and then send it to the back. You're going to need to lock the rectangle in place so it doesn't move around. Finally, flick the hand lettering to a white fill. Looking at David's work on Instagram, I think he used the pen tool to create shapes and then he filled them with a gradient. So grab the pen tool and create a curve where you think the lettering will twist along its path. Use a color that you will be able to see over white. You don't have to be super accurate at this stage because we can go back in afterwards and clean it up. The trick here is to follow the shape of the lettering and make an area for the shadow to fill. Once complete, flick it over to a fill like so, and then grab the direct selection tool so you can go back in and edit the anchor points and the path to make it fit perfectly. I changed the fill to a gradient. Change the direction of your gradient here so that the shadow is coming from one side. Try to imagine a light source coming from a specific area, for example the left. One side of the gradient slider, i.e. the white side, you must turn the opacity down to zero. You can make the other side as dark as you like, but I'm going for a dark grey tone here. Now use this method again to go over all of your typography. If you want to see how to make this technique again, go back a minute or two in the video, rewatch how I did it. So here's my final design. I think it looks great and I have to thank David for the inspiration. There's a link in the description for this image on pixabay.com, which you can download. There'll be no video tomorrow because I'm really, really busy right now with graphic design work, but I'm going to try and live stream at some point tomorrow, so report back to my channel to see if there's a notification for that. Like and share this video if you really enjoyed it, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.